its own bitterness. And a stranger does not intermeddle with his joy. A lot of times, even when you see how the scripture addresses the heart or the soul, does not address it as an it, does not address it as a part of man. It addresses it as an individual by itself. You can be in danger and begin calling people. You can call people for an hour and nobody's helping you, but you still keep on calling. And that 1 hour, if you would have spent it with God, there would have come help. The same time. But because of the things that your soul is hearing, these voices that are addressing your soul, and a lot of times when these voices address the soul, we listen, we pay attention to what they're saying. I give myself away. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. But he will be different to you depending on your belief system. And that is what the devil targets. That's what the devil fights in your life. And it is only the word that you believe that works. All word works, but it works in accordance to your belief system. It is how you believe. So things address your soul. That's why you find you watch the things you watch on TV. Nobody tells you, Go and live an immoral life. Apana. You will never be told that. But a language will be spoken. That which people call the subconscious mind. A language is spoken to that soul. Tamar also did not love Amnon. But the heart of Amnon attracted Tamar to the extent that even if she would have wanted, she could not escape it. That is how some of us are caught up in relationships that do not make sense. Because somebody's heart attracted you. Someone that was not supposed to attract you attracted you. So you begin finding yourself, you've gone for this date, you're drinking coffee, and you're wondering, why on earth am I with this person? In the middle of the night, you're on phone talking to somebody, and you're asking yourself, after the phone call, you're asking yourself, what is wrong with me? How can I talk to so-and-so? What is happening? Their heart. And the things that pain you also pain him. If you could come and offer them, you would be shocked. We've been taught how to clean ourselves up. Groom yourself. Go and pray this prayer. No, go pour your heart. Holy and acceptable. Said if you would have been here. Jesus, if you would have been here, my brother would not be dead. And when she is saying those things, she is still crying. Her tears are still on the feet of Jesus. I give myself away. Bible says, and Jesus wept. Holy and acceptable. And after Jesus wept, he's been dead for 4 days, and by now he's thinking. He says, remove the stone. Lazarus is not being raised because I came to raise him. Lazarus is being raised because someone has poured her heart. Someone has not acted religious. Someone has not tried to put themselves together to look like they are really born again. Someone has poured their hearts. God will satisfy your heart to the extent that you will bless him. May the Lord feed that heart to the point that when you come before him, you cannot even resist. You don't care what people are doing. You don't care what people say after you have done. Why? Because it is your soul that is speaking.
Completely unashamed, I give you my heart unrestrained.